veya iki burmester önce radyal ultrasonla başlamak istediğini ifade etti. Evet, yani şu hastada konuşuyor. Bir, akut pankreatit etiyolojisi neydi? İkincisi, pankreas başındaki kistik lezyonun karakterine. Bu hastaya aslında ben kendim cerrahçıda endoskopi yaptım. Pankreas başında serous histadenoma benzeyen bir kistik lezyonu vardı. Tipik bir görüntüsü vardı. Biyopsi aldım. Serous histadenoma'da beklediğiniz üzere hücreden fakir bir materyal geldi. Fakat ilginç olan şey aynı anda birinci, ikinci kıta kesişiminde bir kitle lezyonu duvarda gördüm. Onu bir diş zannederek biyopsi aldım. Oradan da long brain nörolojik tümör çıktı. Dolayısıyla iki antiteyi barındıran bir hasta olduğu için buraya getirdik. Şimdi söz Ayke'de.
Okay, I leave it to you, Ayke.
Okay,
you can go on.
Come again. So, I'm already in the stomach and in front, you see now I stick the cup with the pancreas, and I think it's a little bit astonishing that the pancreatic duct is dilated, and I think was it in the former in the examination as well or not?
Just a little bit. It was 2.7 at the pancreatic body,
but it looks too much here. So we have to find the reason. It's 3.2626. Okay.
It was more than ago.
So let's have a look whether the cyst has any cartesia. You see that the duct is dilated up to the tail.
So a little bit more pain.
This is the tail here. I rotate the instrument to the right side of the instrument and I can follow now the tail.
There are no signs for cross cartesia.
So there's an accessory spleen here, there, the small one here, there, this one here. I try to get a better overview if you want. So you see it's a very homogeneous. Typical pattern of spleen here, this round part here, this is accessory spleen. So sometimes we have difficulties with these accessory spleens because they can be as well in the spleen, in the pancreatic tail. And they look like, in the tail they are looking like neuroendocrine tumors. In this case it's not difficult, but sometimes we have some cases where we misinterpreted such lesions in the tail as neuroendocrine tumors, and finally it was accessory spleen. So you have to make the
next. We got it.
Okay. So I move now to the direction of the head of the pancreas to have a look whether why the duct is dilated. A little bit difficult to control the cement at the moment. So there's the duct. So this must be the level of the splenopausal constraint somewhere here. But if I try to move downwards, it doesn't work. So the patient is obese. So we have the same problems like in abdominal ultrasound. This is the gallbladder view. This is very important in this case to have as well a look into the gallbladder, because sometimes you see very small cells and you can't see it with the normal abdominal ultrasound. There are some small echoes inside. I think I have no balloon on the instrument, is it right? So this is the gallbladder. So it seems not to be a clear stone. I have a lot of air artifacts here. At the moment I can't see any cysts in the pancreas, so I decide to go down now to the duodenum. So I need the endoscopic view to go down.
perfusion is ready.
Okay. So let's have a look whether we can find this this drug, the submucosal tumor in the duodenum. I don't know the renal level, so we need a little bit of viscopancy. So let's have a look whether I can find it.
Tumor is very small.